Item number, SCP-277. Object class, Euclid. Special containment procedures. Due to the difficulties inherent in containing SCP-277, it has been placed under a level lockdown. Activities of the residents of SCP-277 must be monitored by no less than embedded agents, and civilians are not to be aware of Foundation presence or influence. Any attempts to contact civilians within SCP-277 by those outside SCP-277 must be investigated. Personnel must undergo psychological screening before being assigned to SCP-277. Description: SCP-277 is a moderately populated town and the principal anomaly within SCP-277 are apparitions found throughout the area that seem to be images projected from children's thoughts or imagination. These are collectively referred to as SCP-277-1. Incidents of SCP-277-1 appear as figures drawn in white outlines, with no physical substantiality of their own. The size, style in which they are drawn, and the complexity of the projections vary from child to child. Prepubescent children are the only individuals capable of producing such incidents, and the process of projecting one seems for the most part to be unconscious and involuntary. An average of incidents of SCP-277-1 are present at any given time within the area. While embedded agents are requested to report potentially uncategorized children to their supervisors to be examined, due to the size of SCP-277, the prepubescent population there within, and security complications, this is recognized as occasionally unfeasible. Incidences of SCP-277-1 are capable of interacting with each other, although physical objects pass through, leaving no damage to either party. Children frequently play with their projections, and the existence of SCP-277-1 is regarded as normal by residents of the town. Civilians in SCP-277 claim that the projections have been present within the town since its colonization. This claim is dubious at best, as there are no records of the area's existence before the year 2000, and the towns immediately surrounding the area deny any knowledge of the city. Testing of members within SCP-277 revealed that their dental, fingerprint, and DNA records correspond with no recorded population databases. When under questioning, civilians denied having memories of living or traveling anywhere but within SCP-277. Operation 277. Update the first. Attempt number to evacuate SCP-277 has commenced on 6:15. Small changes were made to the previously detailed methods of evacuation, namely, expunged, in hopes of avoiding what may have caused previous failures. Residents continue to deny any memory of previous evacuation attempts. Personnel members involved in previous assignments involving the suppression of SCP-277-1 and SCP-277-1R in particular seem to have been expunged. More trained personnel and Class D subjects are requested, along with the necessary medical equipment, in the event of another such incident. Operation 277. Update the second. As of 6:23, Operation 277 has proven unsuccessful due to data corrupted. SCP-277-1R demonstrated the ability to render mental damage not only to prepubescents, but to physically mature agents. No further evacuation attempts are to be carried out. Level lockdown suggested. Dr. R. Foundation personnel have been unable to trace the source of file Operation 277. Foundation databanks have been unable to produce an unexpunged copy of the file. No personnel or civilians in the area are able to recall any attempts made to evacuate, and the legitimacy of the file has been called into question multiple times. As per common consensus, however, no further evacuation efforts have been planned. Furthermore, it has been discovered that when a resident of SCP-277 leaves the area for several minutes, they are violently data expunged, and then may be found within the area, with no memory of departing from the area. Addendum 277A. As of 9:14, An unaccounted for SCP-277-1 was photographed in the local library by a Foundation agent. No one in the vicinity claimed to be responsible for the projection, as the appearance and actions of incidents of SCP-277-1 are often telling of a child's psychological profile. Efforts are being taken to identify the owner of these projections. Designated SCP-277-1-R. Projections that match the image shown in drawing style or behavior are to be reported immediately. Addendum 277-B. Sightings of projections that are similar to SCP-277-R have tripled in frequency since 9/23. On 10/5, there were several child casualties made by members of SCP-277-R upon children's projections. Interview 277-A. Interviewed: Agent Davis. Interviewer: Dr. A. Begin log. Dr. A. Right then, please begin at the point where you first saw the SCP-277. Agent Davis: Well, I was walking to a local diner after the end of my shift when I saw a cluster of them across the street. Dr. A: It would be helpful if you could include as many details as you can recall, Davis. Agent Davis: They were in the form of, rabbits. Most of those are, for some reason. Regular kids imagine things from spaceships to magic beanstalks within an hour, but all I've seen drawn in that style are rabbits. They were huddled at a street intersection, watching the passing people and cars, I think. They don't move very much or play like the other sketches. That's what the personnel there have taken to calling them, sketches. Mostly they watch others. Dr. A: You weren't alarmed by them? Agent Davis: What? No. No, they were pretty common by then. They didn't really do anything hostile, so the hype about them had calmed down. Dr. A: Noted. Please continue. Agent Davis: Right. Well, after I walked by them, I heard this kid scream from behind me. Little girl, maybe 8 years old. She'd been playing with her sketch when I passed, this winged pony thing. So I turn around and one of the rabbits is on her sketch. I've never seen anything moving that fast, and it was, the closest thing I can think of is consuming it, while the girl was going into some type of seizure. I had trouble making sense of what I was seeing at first. It looked like one huge white scribble in the air. There was no helping the girl. I was holding her so she wouldn't hurt her head against the concrete, but I'm no doctor. More of the rabbits had reached other sketches by then, and those sketches too were being torn apart, and the kids were all screaming. And according to the documents I've been given, this was happening all over the town, right? Dr. A: That's correct. Agent Davis: I unloaded a load of shots into the thing, but of course that didn't help. Don't really know why I did that. They're all in comas now, aren't they? The kids? Dr. A: Yes, they are. I think that will be all, Agent Davis. Agent Davis: One last thing. Dr. A: Yes. Agent Davis: May I request to be transferred out of SCP-277? Dr. A: You have already been reassigned to SCP- Agent Davis: Thanks. Goodbye, then, Doctor. End log. Update: 3 months following this incident, members of SCP-277-R have vanished from the area. It is still unknown whether they were projections from a child or a manifestation native to SCP-277 itself. Addendum 277-C. Inquiries made to civilians regarding the incident on 10/5 have returned with mixed results. A number of the residents claimed that they had never witnessed such an occurrence before and expressed desire for Foundation officials to quickly identify and prosecute the perpetrator. Others claim that similar events happen periodically, every years. Personnel staffing SCP-277 have expressed discomfort when dealing with members of the town. They smile too wide, as if this entire place is just a fairy tale, and that massacre was just part of their happy ending. Agent J. Lesson complete. If you missed the previous orientation, go watch SCP-276. Time Schooner, right now. Or for the complete course, Watch this playlist.